Hi, I'm Dan Brown at ONICON. Today we'll be demonstrating how to properly install your clamp-on ultrasonic transducers onto your pipe. The first thing you're going to want to do before you get started is make sure that you've located a straight run-up pipe that meets the requirements in the meter manual.
With every meter comes insulation hardware, along with your transducer and bracket pair. There are three different styles of brackets and transducers, depending on your pipe size. Today we'll be dealing with the Series 20 transducers and their brackets. Not included with the flow meter, but needed for successful installation, is a 5/16 inch nut driver. It is important to verify the pipe size by measuring the circumference using a tape measure.
Use sandpaper to repair the pipe surface. Remove any rough surfaces or scale. A smooth pipe surface is necessary to ensure a quality signal for the transducers. To avoid air bubbles disrupting your ultrasonic signals and horizontal pipes, don't place your transducers on the top of the pipe. Instead, place them on the sides of the pipe. Now with the hose clamps provided, mount your brackets to the pipe.
Guide the hose clamp through the slot on the top of the bracket. Place the bracket on the pipe at the prepared location and hand tighten in place. Repeat this process with the second bracket, using the spacing ruler to align the brackets parallel to the pipe. Use your 5/16 nut driver to tighten the pipe clamps, securing the bracket. Adjust the second bracket to the distance specified on your installation location document. Verify the pipe information and prescribed transducer spacing by accessing the setup menu. Press the right arrow key once to access the main menu. Scroll down to setup and press the right arrow key again. Once inside the setup screen, scroll down to view the pipe information. If the pipe is different than ordered, it can also be changed on the screen. Press the right arrow key on each setting to access. Use the up and down arrow key to change selections, and hit the check button to apply. The transducer spacing will automatically update. Tighten both brackets firmly against the pipe once properly located. Apply a line of coupling along the bottom face of the transducer to ensure the ultrasonic sound waves properly travel into the pipe. Place the transducer into the bracket. Make sure the front of the transducer is in line with the front of the bracket, and that the arrow is facing the other transducer. Tighten the screw at the top of the bracket to firmly press the transducer against the pipe. Do not over-tighten. Repeat this process with the other transducer. Again, the arrows on both transducers should be facing each other.
To complete your transducer installation, attach the cable to the coax terminal on top of the transducer. The cables are marked upstream and downstream. Ensure that you install the proper cable to the correct transducer based on the pipe's flow direction.
For the F4300, the transducer cable should be terminated inside the unit as shown, with the upstream transducer cable on the left terminal and the downstream transducer cable on the right. Note that the green wires of both cables are positioned on the inside. The order of the wires must be gray, green, green, gray. Miswiring your transducer cables will result in poor readings. To verify the signal quality of the ultrasonic transducers installed on the pipe, access the text menu by holding the check button and then pressing the right arrow key. The echo size should be approximately 1000 millivolts, the signal strength should be around 100%, and the signal gain should be less than 100.
So that wraps up our video on how to install a clamp-on ultrasonic transducer. For any other questions, contact our technical support team. They'll be happy to help you. I've been Dan Brown. Thank you for watching.